Hello and welcome back to another video. My name is Mike Davies, and in today's tutorial, I'll be showing you how to create an Instagram carousel using GIMP. I'll be using GIMP version 2.10.22, which is the latest version of GIMP at the time of this tutorial. Before I get into that, don't forget to check out my website at daviesmediadesign.com. As always, I have tons of GIMP, Inkscape, and Darktable tutorials on here. You can get more by becoming a DMD Premium member, and I have tons of free software help articles, so definitely check that out. You can enroll in my GIMP 2.10 Masterclass from beginner to pro photo editing on Udemy. And as I mentioned, you can get more with a premium membership to Davies Media Design, and I'll include a link to this as well as all the relevant links from this tutorial in the description of the video. So here is the final composition we'll be creating for today's tutorial. I'll also be showing you how to upload the result to Instagram and get that carousel effect. So this is a pretty easy effect to create. Let's dive right in. I'll start by opening up the original image here, so I can do that by going to File, Open, and search on my computer, or in my case, I'll go to Open Recent, and here is that image. There's a couple of things you're gonna wanna figure out first. So number one, how many images do you wanna split this up into? And then secondly, what size do you want these images to be? So in my case, I know I want this to be a 1080 by 1080 pixel square, and I want there to be 3 images. So that's how we're gonna divide this up. So for starters, I'll come over here and grab my crop tool. And I'll make sure this is set to fixed aspect ratio and that it is checked. And I'm gonna set the aspect ratio to 3:1 because we're gonna split this up into 3 even images. And now I'm gonna click on my composition and click and drag my mouse. That will draw this crop area. And I do have my guides here set to rule of thirds, and I'm just going to center this up. So you can see, because we have a split in 2/3, it is telling us exactly where our image is gonna be broken up. Once I'm ready, I'll click inside the crop. Next, I need to scale this image down because it's too big. So I'm gonna scale this so that the height is set to 1080. So I'll go to Image, Scale Image, and I'm gonna set this to 1080, hit the Tab key. Because we already cropped this with a 3:1 aspect ratio and we have this little chain link icon locked, that's gonna automatically update this to the width we need. And also the interpolation here is set to no halo, which is gonna give us pretty much the best quality. So I'll hit scale. All right, so our image is at 3240 by 1080. I'll hold control and zoom in with my mouse wheel. Next, we need to split our image up into 3 equal parts, and we're gonna do that using the guides. So I'll grab my move tool here and just click 2 random guides from the rulers. Doesn't matter where you place them at first. Hit the Q key to grab the alignment tool. I'm gonna set this relative to image. And what I need to do is offset this at 1/3 and 2/3 of the way. And because we know that each one of our images is gonna be 1080 pixels wide, because remember this is a 1080 by 1080 pixels square, that means I can offset one of these guides at 1080 and then the second one at 1080 times 2. So let's click on the first guide here. And you can tell the guide is selected with the alignment tool because it'll have these little squares. And I'll come over here to offset X. And I'm going to set this to 1080. And then I'm going to click the distribute left button. That's going to distribute this so that it is now located at exactly 1080. So let me come over here, click on the second image. 1080 times 2 is 2160. And once again, we're going to left align it. So there is our second guide, and that's going to divvy up our image into 3 equal images. If you wanted to add text or graphics to your various images, now is the time to do that. So if I come back over here to the original image, this is what my original graphics look like. So we are going to create these. I'll start by coming over here to the arrow. I'm not going to go over in detail how I made this for this tutorial just for the sake of time, but basically I just used the paths tool and I also placed some guides to draw a triangle. I will make this available for download on my website, but let's come over here and grab the arrow layer and just click and drag this over to our composition. Make sure we hover our mouse over the image or the canvas and release. So there's our arrow. It's a bit too big right now, so I'll hit Shift S on the keyboard to grab my scale tool. And I can either scale this down using the handles or just come over here and manually type in the size I want. So let's go with 100 by 100 and hit scale. I'll hit the M key on my keyboard, and I'm just gonna move this down here And there's a little crosshair in the middle of this layer. So I'm gonna have that snap to the guide there. What I wanna do is now create that sort of train of arrows I had going on. So I think I had 5 different arrows. So to do that, I'll come over here and I'm gonna copy this layer. So right now we have one of these, we need 5. So I'll hit the duplicate icon 4 times. So that'll give us 5 different arrow layers. Now what I'll do is come over here and grab my rectangle select tool. And I'm just gonna randomly draw a rectangle here. And I'm gonna have this around 630. You can see the size over here. So the width I did for this is 630. And what I'll do is just drag this until it snaps to that same guide so it's nice and centered. Once I've done that, I'll come over here and click on my image layer. That way we have the full selection. Now I'll hit the Q key on my keyboard to grab the alignment tool. And I'm gonna click and drag my alignment tool over all 5 arrows. And then I'll come over here relative to and change this to selection. And then under distribute, I'm going to distribute targets evenly in the horizontal. And I'm gonna hit Control Z. The reason that didn't work out is I need to come over here and change the offset back to 0. And then once I've done that, I can come over here and distribute this once again. And now we have these 5 arrows. So once we have that, we can hit Control Shift A to deselect the selection area. You can also go to select none. So now let's put all these on the same layer. I'm gonna come up top here and just merge all of the arrow layers together using this merge icon until we have a single layer. And we can rename this. So we'll go with arrows, hit the enter key. We're gonna duplicate this. So now we have 2 of these layers. And we are going to move these in a bit. But first, what we'll do is add our text. So I'll come over here, grab my text tool. The font I have is Enrique. That is a free font. I do have an entire tutorial on how to download and install free fonts for GIMP. I'll link it to this video. The size is set to 100 here, and you'll see my letter spacing is set to 25. So once I have all my settings, I'm just gonna click on my composition, and with the caps lock key on, I'll type train. Now I'm gonna click to create another text box without, and then click over here, limits. Next, what I wanna do is move the text and the arrows into place. So I'll come over here to my toolbox and grab the move tool. I'm going to place a guide where I want all of these elements, so probably about right there. And now I can click and drag this up top here. Make sure you're hovered over the actual text. The pixels in the text. So we'll place that about right there, and now we'll move the arrows like so. And we can adjust these so that nothing's overlapping. Make sure you're on the actual pixels of the text. And finally, if you wanted to make sure that everything was center aligned on the page, you can come over here to Image, Guides, New Guide by Percent. Direction will be vertical, position 50, and click OK. And we'll come over here and click the little transform lock icon on all of these, everything except for the main image layer. And with the move tool still selected, we can now move this until that center area snaps there to that center guide. And now we can move this guide off the page as well as this guide here. So now I'm just going to click and drag my logo onto here. And this is just a fictitious company. I actually designed this logo in another tutorial, which I will link to this video. But what we'll do is we'll scale this logo down. So I'll hit Shift S on my keyboard, scale this down a bit, drag it over here to this corner and hit scale. And the last thing I did before I split everything up is I just added a layer mode to these. So all of them have the same layer mode. So they were all set to grain merge. So I'm just going to do that for all of these. Now we're going to split this composition up into 3 different images and then upload those to Instagram. So to do that, we're going to come over here to Image and then Slice using Guides. So that's just going to slice the image into 3 different images exactly at the guides positions. So you can see here, now we have 3 different compositions. You want to make sure up top here that all of these are exactly the same. So all of these should be 1080 by 1080. And once you've confirmed that, now we can export each one of these. So I'll go to File, Export As. So we'll navigate here to the folder where I want to save these and just name this one Slice 1, hit the Enter key. And the quality is fine here. Instagram is going to automatically compress this anyway. But you'll see I am exporting this as a JPEG. I'll do the same for this one. File, export as. All right, once we've exported all of our images out of GIMP, now we need to upload them to Instagram. So you can use whatever device you usually use to upload your projects to Instagram. I'm gonna use my phone. I typically email myself the photos and then upload them through my phone. All right, once you have your images uploaded to whatever device you're using to post to Instagram, again, in this case, I'm using my phone. Once you're logged into Instagram, you're gonna add a post the way you usually would. So click that little plus sign. We're gonna click on post. And in my case, I've limited what Instagram can see on my phone. So I'll come over here to manage to select more photos. So click select more photos. And here I can select the photos I wanna use. So I wanna add these three that we just designed. I'll click done. So now you can see the three photos we're trying to use here. We have 1, 2, 3. So I'm gonna click this little icon to upload multiple photos. And the order of these does matter. So you can see by default, mine has a 1 right here. That is actually the very first photo we want in the order here for the carousel. So the middle image is gonna be number 2, and then the far right image will be number 3. And that just happens to be the order these are in right here. But once you're ready, hit next. If I start swiping over, it's gonna be basically one continuous image. I can make additional edits to this, but I'll just hit next. And I can write something here. I'm gonna delete this when I'm done with this tutorial, but I'll just hit share. And now you'll see here when I scroll over to the right, this is gonna scroll as one continuous image. All right, so that's it for this tutorial. Hopefully you liked it. If you did, don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon to be notified each time I have a brand new tutorial. You can check out any of the links to my resources in the description of the video, but thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.